Welcome to another Visit podcast. Today we got some exciting news. We got the first ever human trials with stem cell therapy focused on, yes, neurodegenerative disorder, specifically Parkinson's disease. Now, this is done by Blu Rock Therapeutics. It's a phase one clinical trial, the first one ever. And it's also with Bayer, the pharmaceutical company. Now, yes, of course, once they can develop drugs specifically, then it becomes interesting to do clinical trials on stem cells, because if you're just doing stem cells, then there's nothing specific to sell. But here we have a specific thing. They've created, and I'm going to read this because it's one of these long names, Bemdane Procell. BRTDA01. It's a stem cell derived investigational property for the treatment of Parkinson's disease. The brain is composed of gray and white matter containing millions of nerve cells. These nerve cells, or neurons, communicate through the release of chemicals called neurotransmitters. Once a neuron is stimulated, a neurotransmitter is released from the neuron and it crosses a gap called a synapse, then binds to the receptor on another neuron, passing the signal. Parkinson's disease is a degeneration of the area of the brain responsible for muscle movement, specifically the pigmented neurons located in the substantia nigra of the midbrain. The destruction of these neurons results in a decreased availability of dopamine, which is a type of neurotransmitter. As a result, nerves in this area cannot send their signal to other nerves in order to direct specific body movements. The result is body tremors, slow down movement, rigidity, and balance problems. Now, before we start, I want to go over what the treatment is now for Parkinson's. And when we look at that, and it's been like this, it's standardized, we're using a levodopa. Levodopa basically increases the dopamine release. It helps the brain where it can't, but it has a lot of side effects. So together with that, people are using carbidopa, and that's because they're trying to basically reduce the side effects. And the side effects such as nausea, vomiting, low blood pressure, restlessness, and reduces the amount of levodopa that's also needed for the treatment. Another thing that they're using, I think, in treating this is dopamine agonist to stimulate production, enzyme inhibitors, MAOB inhibitors, COMT inhibitors. And you can see them using amantadine to help reduce involuntary movements, anticholinergic drugs to reduce tremors and muscle rigidity. Also, deep brain stimulation is being used, but really nothing is resolving the problem. It's just basically treating the symptoms and having these patients, in the end, the patient usually dies. I've had close friends and also had a case in my house with a grandparent that suffered from this and passed away a week ago. And one of the things that you note is that at a later stage, you also can get Parkinson's dementia, which is called the Lewy body dementia. And this is terrible. It's just debilitating. People get bedridden. They can't function anymore. And then your body just starts shutting down. All right. The way we categorize Parkinson's is by using the Hauser diary, which categorizes patients as being in the on state when their symptoms are well controlled, and in the off state when they experience worsening of the symptoms. Participants in the high dose cohort showed an improvement of 2.16 hours in time spent on the on state without troubling dyskinesia compared with baseline after 1 year. Time spent in the off state showed a corresponding decrease of 1.91 hours after 1 year. This is some of the results. So the initial results of the stem cell therapy that we've seen are amazing. It's only phase one of the study, which is done. They're starting a phase two now. It included 12 participants. Two had issues, but they were non-related to the treatment, which was, I think one had COVID and the other one had something else, which I don't recall right now, but it wasn't related. That was all fixed, ameliorated, and they continued. What did the study show? Let's get to the study. Now that we know what we're doing regularly for it, but this study is amazing because, one, it showed that initially, once they do the study, they have to see, okay, is it safe? Yes, it was safe, came out safe. Is there any reaction of the body against the stem cells or against the medication? Is our immune system freaking out? No, there was none of that. It was well tolerated by all 12 participants. Okay, how do we determine if it works? How do we see? How do we analyze? They're using an 18F DOPA PET imaging scan. So this is used to visualize the excess of dopamine activity in Parkinson's disease patients. So they did this to show, okay, is it increasing? Is it getting better, etc., right? Both low dose and high dose treatments in the cohort improved in clinical endpoints, with the high dose being the best. And this was assessed by the Unified Parkinson's Disease Rating Scale, Part 3, and the Hauser Diary. All right, so they've really were able to look at it and say, wow, these people improved, right, themselves. Why? The stem cells are regenerative. The stem cells were able to regenerate these neurons and basically have the body itself start producing more dopamine. This is amazing. This is a breakthrough. So the results were phenomenal. Okay, we see with the high dose and the low dose improvements, the high dose beating out the low dose. And we see improvements also in end results, meaning that the brain actually started producing more dopamine, neurons were fixed, and they did, and they, of course, checked the normal points, what they do with Parkinson's to see how far the disease is and how debilitating it is. The initial results, phenomenal. They're doing round two, which is starting, and that's going to be they're going to basically take more patients. But the takeaway here is, one, it was safe. Two, there was no immune issues with it. And three, we're seeing that it's just giving the results we're looking for. So this is the first. And not only that, but this is the first stem cell clinical trials ever, anywhere. So we need to keep an eye on it. Again, the companies are Blu Rock Therapeutics, and that's part of Bayer, the pharmaceutical company. So props to them, and I'll be keeping an eye on this study on the second phase and hoping that they can release probably, I don't know, after the trials, maybe end of next year. It's going to take a year. The second trial might take a little more than a year. This took 18 months. They're looking at it. So the next batch will be probably the same length, maybe a little longer. It's all good. Very promising. So we're very hopeful. There's a big group of people that suffer from Parkinson's, and it's a debilitating disease. It's a neurodegenerative that you really don't want to have or get. So that's the news from this side. Hey, hit the bell notifications, subscribe. Let's grow this channel. We got great stuff coming. We got more stuff coming. Take care.